I'm here at this time of the day before the night, hit by music coming from the other room, overflowing like a flood. It's caught up in our gloominess and fears. Try, baby, try to win back your love again. I'll be there. Say the lyrics of the song. And her tears fall regardless, caressing her cheeks. And woman holding on to life fully, impatiently, just like a baby falling over and picking herself up again and again, letting the limitless, hurtful, mad, sad journey of feelings carry her away, knowing so well that it will make her bleed. Maybe not today, but tomorrow. Maybe not tomorrow, not the next day, but eventually it is going to make her bleed. Woman is now alone. She's used to her loneliness. And woman doesn't miss man anymore, because she has recreated man within herself. She knows now whether man is there or not, whether she can touch him or not. Man is within and all around her in every moment. When woman knows herself, she finds love. And the more she reaches that love, the more she can recreate man within herself in every moment.
And man is listening to the laughter, song, silence. The sounds are creeping into the room, echoing, re-echoing. Vivian, man, mind, sense, love, artful. And the back and forth movement of this chair. How many years ago was it before my spreading midriff, before my gray hair, before my frozen feelings? How many months, years, centuries ago was it? And this expressionless face turns into a bizarre mask shaped by the complexity of pain and yearning. And man starts talking to himself. I don't know why I have so much passion for you. Why am I still feeling suffocated by the grief all the years gone by? You are with me every moment, everywhere I can touch you if I reach out, yet man is now alone. But his fears have multiplied.
And woman is searching for love. And maybe love is also searching for woman. Maybe woman has to search for love or she will lose her hope. Her head is always full of her feelings, joys, hopes, hopelessness, past and future. And of course, in fact, she's always searching but never finding. Just when she says she has found it, she realizes that her hands are empty. Maybe her aim is not to find, just to search. She believes that this way she can escape disappointment. Searching full of hope. How strange this lack of faith, this hope in hopelessness and man and love. Woman has always been silent. Woman has always questioned. Woman has always lived. Woman has always lost. Woman has always won. Woman has always spoken. Woman has always rejoiced. Woman has always hoped. Woman has always been sad. Woman has always given, woman has always taken, woman has always made love, woman has always been ashamed, woman has always been afraid, woman has always explained, woman has always understood. While trying to live like a woman, She has always pursued women. Women had a name, women didn't have a name. But the limitations of womanhood always existed for her. Limits scared women away from her own womanhood.
And man is escaping from love. And he thinks he's protecting man while he's on the run. Man is searching for man. Maybe he enjoys escaping, better than facing his fears and losing all his power. Yet, man is scared to death of powerlessness. His head is always full of his thoughts, his questions, answers, plans, hopes, hopelessness, his past, his tomorrows, and above all, woman. He always has so much on his mind, always planning, and words. He gets so wrapped up in words that his feelings slip through his fingers, and he is always searching for them. Perhaps he doesn't mean to search for them at all. But because he cannot accept the fact that they slip away, he is always trying to find what is eluding him. He believes that this is the only way he can distance himself from his disappointments, hopeful that he will find them. How strange this lack of faith, searching for hope in hopelessness, and woman, and love. Man has always run away. Man has always chased. Man has always spoken. Man has always fought. Man has always fucked. Man has always taken. Man has never given. Man has always given. Man has always loved. Man has always been loved. Man has always lost. Man has always won. Man has always been alone. Man has always been in a crowd. Man has always worked. Man is always in the name. Always chased after being a man, to become man. As a child, silenced when he cried, ashamed when he laughed out loud. Couldn't cry, couldn't laugh. Attempted to become a man while still a child. While always existing at the limits of being a man, he has always been afraid to become a man. Being used when he thought he was using, with his cries for freedom and justice, he created war while demanding order. He dared to write love with blood. When he attempted to protect love with power, man became pitiful. While his life slips out of his hands in the name of being a man, he abandoned love and worshipped power.
And woman is now feeling a new and complexity she has never felt before. But when everything started, when everything ended, or even when their love fell short, wanting to give voice to what she has inside. This is beyond everything. She can't run away or afraid to stay. She has never felt so helpless. Like a helpless baby. Just like a marble spinning on the same spot, always the same spot, same cycle, same pain, always the same, always the same. Woman, in fact, knows all the tricks. The desire to be tricked, it hurts her to be consciously tricked. Reading all those tricks with her eyes. To and from his eyes. And still.
A man is lying on a picture, eyes closed. If you couldn't hear him breathing, you might think he's dead. So isolated. The restlessness of his thought, the stillness of his pain, his questions, contradictions, or pleas. If only he could clear his mind of the pressure, which gets more intense the more he wants to escape
If you could only separate those cloying feelings from that strangeness that all over. Really, what is it called? That peculiar passion. Too cliche. Love? Huh? Do you? Excitement? Maybe a part of it. But then what is that? That strangeness. He's giving all his attention to his surroundings in order to escape from everything that is in his mind. While his eyes began to wander around in the garden, distracted by the grass, by the flowers, and by the church town next door. Church. Abstraction. Paint. Priests. Church. His thoughts made him smile. My priesthood is autonomous, without any need of buildings, ceremonies, or rules, roads of office.
And woman finds herself in pitch darkness, without a beginning, without an end, without a reason. There is no distress, or pain, or happiness, or any other expression on her face, like a statue, as if she is alive, lifelessly. Her breathing, the only sign of life. She will be filled with ashes if she buries herself even a little deeper in her past. I can't bear it anymore, she says, pleading. She is in a strange state of mind, and she wants to snap out of it. But at the same time, never wants to get over it at all. Just like a woman is stuck. She can neither tear herself away from her past nor give shape to her future. Just like that, drifting from one moment to another. Her fears wrapped all around her. Wherever she turns, she faces them.
The man is complicated. For a long, long time, his feelings have been harbored in a safe haven, protected from the winds, rain, storm, resistant. But now, as if all his chains were broken, he finds a fearful pain inside the storm. See, he was running away from his heartache. He nurtured a hungry wolf in his heart, always demanding more and more and more. When it wakes up, his heart hurts. But now he's tired and wants peace. And man wants to go to the mountains. He can't carry his tired heart anymore. His mobile next to him, the same scent in his nose. Sadness inside him. And he wants to be gone. Sleep, maybe. Though nowadays, there's no sleep, there's no peace in his sleep. He wants to cry. Pull out the contradictions inside him, the tears, the yearnings, and woman. Maybe then he will calm down. Then. Is it that easy? Or is it that difficult?
Woman wrote a letter to man, which he will never receive. I'm scared to touch him, as I don't know how to touch him. I'm scared to touch you as your skin blends with my skin. I'm scared to touch you as I know I will be imprisoned by you with every cell of my body. I'm scared to touch you, as I will risk losing you if you touch another woman. I'm scared to touch you, as you are my lifeblood. You belong to me so deeply that losing you would mean the end of my existence. I'm most scared by my contradictions, because I am beyond love. Woman wrote a letter to man, which you will receive. When I make love with you, I'm scared of everything. Your hand wandering on my skin and your skin touching mine. I connect with universe when you and Moshe becomes my Moshe. I disappear in you. And as I disappear, I can recreate myself. I think of tomorrow and I'm scared of not knowing what is going to happen. When you and me and time and love are beyond everything.
Man wrote a letter to woman, which woman will never receive. I'm scared of touching you, as I want to touch you more and more. I'm scared of touching you, as neither your hands, legs, hips, nor your eyes are enough. I'm scared of touching you, as my hands, legs, eyes, and tongue would never feel enough. I'm scared of touching you, as I will be jealous if another man touches you. I'm scared of touching you, in case there you abandon me. If you abandon me, I will never be able to touch you again. And the moment I can't touch you, I won't exist anymore. I'm scared, most of loving. To love you. Man wrote a letter to woman, which she will receive. When I make love with you, I'm not scared of anything. When I'm sucking your nipple, tongue, toes, when I'm sucking you, I suck the whole universe. I suck myself. I don't think of tomorrow, and I'm not scared of it. For the sake of the moment they live, I put time on hold and love you forever.
Woman clung on to the light particles from the well that she fell into. The more woman clung to the particles, the more she got torn into pieces. Not knowing what she was looking for, she believed she could find answers. The more she reached out to men, thinking that they could show her the way out from the well, she sank deeper in the dark. Woman turned to the inside. She was fading into the dark, and then she flew to the light particles. In the end, she was a stranger even to herself. The darkness of the well she had fallen into. Instead of accepting the darkness she was going through, she chased the comfort of lies and thought of herself as woman, even though she couldn't become one. Woman always refused to understand that you can't be born a woman, but you become. She was in search of a man who could make her a woman, even though she never wanted to put it into words. She ran away from the realization that when she defined her womanhood by surrounding her body with prejudices and obligations, she became more distant from her womanhood. Woman was searching for woman. Woman was longing for woman. Woman wanted to unite with her body. Woman had vanished. Woman wanted to exist. Perhaps while woman was searching for woman, she was searching for man. In the end, woman decided to undress herself.
While words were slipping through his fingers, man hoped woman could collect them, give them new meanings, and bring them all back to him.
Woman felt numb as she grasped the meaning of the words. Whatever is real is illusion, and whatever is illusion is real.
Now, whenever man looked at the mirror, he saw that he wasn't naked anymore, even though he had no clothes on.
Woman, in complete stillness, realizing that for years what she has been searching for is her escape.
Man realized that his escaping had come to an end and that all his arrivals had been escaped.
Woman learned that words could be undressed.
Man accepted that when he spoke about his feelings, he was never straightforward.
Woman touched the simplicity. diversity of meaning.
When man undressed woman.
And when woman undressed man.
They both panicked, knowing that they would have to coexist with all the other reality.
The more they panicked, the more they wrapped around each other. The more they wrapped around each other, the more they undressed. The more they undressed, the more they purified. And woman and man tried vanishing for the sake of existing within one another.
And man and woman tried vanishing for the sake of existing within one another.
Woman is sitting at the edge of life, watching time. Time is just like woman, accepted by everyone that it exists. Even though the reality of it has never been understood, time and women know that they have understood each other forever, just like they know that they don't exist and know that everyone constantly tells them that they do exist. Time can't put its non-existence into words, neither can woman.
Man understands what woman can't explain.
Woman sitting at the edge of life, missing man. One of the few luxuries left for her is to miss man, to wait and miss him, to miss him and wait. Woman is like a leaf, connected to its tree, bound to its branch, waiting in complete stillness to become green, to turn yellow, to fall, then to grow again. Woman's faith is the same as a leaf that has to bear the cold, heat, wind, rain, just like a leaf which is bound to do whatever the tree wishes.
Man recognizes woman's loneliness most of the time. Man touches his own loneliness through woman's loneliness. Maybe it's her acceptance that brings woman closest to man.
Woman is sitting at the edge of life, caressing her tears lovingly. Maybe woman's tears define her at most. Silent, meaningful, and alone. Even though each tear drops one after another, even more, two drops at the same time from both eyes, each teardrop is on its own, alone. Her tears are her scars, her yearnings, her loves, her pains, defining her, perhaps, that single tear dropping from her eye.
Besides, man loves woman the most when she cries. Finds her face the most beautiful when washed with her tears. Even though man never tells, he knows what her tears say.
Woman is sitting at the edge of life, just like that. Split from her past, her future is full of possibilities. Woman wants to dream a day later, a week later, for happier days to come. She can't dream anymore. Woman has no dreams anymore.
Man doesn't know how to dream. That's why he doesn't know how painful it is for woman to lose her dreams. Man is shaping his future by knowing that from now on he can never be apart from woman.
In order to exist in this dangerous world full of risk, woman loses herself in a labyrinth of choices most of the time. The lost woman searched for a way out, not through herself, but through men. All her searching brought her alone to a dead end because she refused to believe that men's thought patterns were so simple. And because she couldn't believe this, she always loaded meanings onto man's actions and words. With each new meaning she bestowed onto man, she faded away even more. One day, woman and man caught each other's eye.
One day, man and woman caught each other's eye. When man's eye caught woman's eye, he got excited. However, for man to get excited was as simple as eating and drinking. And because it was simple, it was right. What was important was not what woman thought, but only for men to want.
When woman's eye caught man's eye, she got excited being wanted by him. Woman who praised the simple man's simple desire. The first thing woman perceived was not her want of him, but his want of her.
For man, what woman was thinking was not important.
For woman, what man was thinking was very important.
Man was striving to reach woman's body.
Woman wanted his body and his mind.
Clashing desires created chaos.
Woman needed definitions, meanings, feelings, she said. Love?
For man, reality was simple enough. He said, what?
Woman insisted.
Man resisted.
Woman insisted.
At the end, man found a simple solution. I can't stop loving you as long as you love me too. A simple trait.
Woman asked for the thousandth time, is loving you not enough?
Man replied all in one breath, but you didn't show any affection.
Woman is confused. I love you.
Man is angry. I love you too.
Woman asked for the thousandth time, but how?
Man replied at once, I am honest, you see?
Woman is open. I love you, whether you are honest or not.
Man is angry. I am weak.
Woman asked for the man for the thousandth time, what was it that I couldn't make clear while I was loving you?
Man replied all in one breath, neither your love nor you is enough for me.
Woman is gloomy. Reason within feelings.
Man is ambitious. Feelings within reason.
Woman confused for the thousandth time. Is the love I have not enough?
Man wasn't confused at all. Don't pity me.
Woman is sad. What kind of logic is this?
Man is anxious. Do you love me?
Woman is still. I'm losing my mind.
Man is still. I'm very scared.